De Dakar Rally is weer van start gegaan en evenals de voorgaande jaren doet ook de lokale raceheld Tim Coronel samen met zijn tweelingbroer Tom weer mee.
Here we are in Lima on the seaside in Peru, getting ready for the Dakar. The last preparations are being done by the mechanics. And all we have to do is the scrutineering and then we are ready for the Dakar.
De eerste week van de Dakar Rally zit er inmiddels op. We kunnen nu gaan kijken naar een uitgebreide samenvatting van de eerste week.
We started building the Beast Part 2 in April last year and the team was really convinced that we could do it in Holland ourselves. And we did it. And it was more work than we thought, but that's normal with racing. And the main changes are the weight, the heating problems. Last year we had a lot of heating problems, so that's what we worked on. And of course, to have a nice design. And that took us about 20 weeks, so I hope you like it. Yeah, the core of the team is about the same as last year, but we have more people, of course. And these people came helping building the car, so everybody knows every bolt, every screw, every wire.
Yeah, in Peru there are a lot of dunes, especially in the first few stages, and my brother is very strong on that part, so there he will be the driver. But of course I will drive as well, because stage 4 or 5 there will be also some rocks and some other parts, and that's going to be my drive.
Yep, everything went well. Scrutineering.
Nice sound.
Oh. Yeah, we're driving just now in Lima.
Okay, Tim, here we are.
Yeah.
In the Park Vermee.
Park Vermee, we are here.
Yep, het gaat gebeuren.
Oh, here, moet je dit zien. Watch this.
Dit is mooi, dit is mooi.
Just before the first stage, very excited of course. We did such a big job, everybody, and I'm really eager to let the beast out.
It's normal that you're a little bit tense, especially for the first stage. But you know, this is it, it's going to begin. 1 year of work, we're ready. Until now we had no difficulties with the car all the way up there. Let's wait and see, because it's always exciting, you know. Once it started, it relieves yourself and you get less stressed, but now, stop it. I just want to start.
Thank you.
guys here, we only did like 300 meters.
It's so, the same route last year, but then the opposite way around. So so we saw some points and we said, we remember, we got stuck here last year.
And here, and here, and here. But today was really good.
Finally, you've seen some dunes, you feel the car, you feel each other. So I'm happy we're here.
Today will be a difficult day, second day. The track is going to be hard, dunes and fast track, so let's have fun. 340 kilometers.
Came in last year here 24 hours later, so yeah, I guess we did a good job.
There wasn't even a finish anymore, everybody left. But yeah, there were so a few recognition points, but it all went well. Two very, very, very dirty dune zones. It was very, very steep down. I even hit my teeth. I broke something on my teeth. I was looking at my road book and Tim went down and cock, and I went.
Yeah.
But that was it.
No.
It all went well. There were some high speed stuff, nice along the beach. It was a good one. It was nice.
And you had some special navigation help?
Oh, yes. Etienne Lavigne, he stopped us with the helicopter and he came to us in the car and he told us,
one valley
more to the left. So we went over the dune and that was it. Yeah, he gave us the right navigation.
Today is going to be a tough day. We have a special stage of 330 kilometer, which is quite heavy, as we remember last year this stage. But but the car feels nice. Somehow everything is in a perfect flow. So let's wait and see what it will bring, because they always have some surprises here at the Dakar Rally. But we feel confident. We'll be right back.
We are now aiming for top 20 positions today, I see.
That was going very well. We had a few problems. One problem was a flat tire. So we had to stop and change the tire. And we were in the Rio. We were really braking the car. The Rio was smaller than the car.
We went into the Rio like this. And I kept full throttle.
Full throttle.
Boom, 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 and floop.
And then after 500 meters, there was an exit. Maybe. We did it.
I say, we are in Peru now in Arequipa with the boss, Tom Coronel. You know, the people say in Peru, hey, Robby Gordon, shut up. I say, Tom Coronel.
Yes. Good, eh?
Yeah.
Ik keek naar je en ik deed de wielen. Kijk nou zelf. Maar de wielen gleden weg door die heuvel. Dus doe het niet zo raar.
Ik zag je in de spiegel kijken, niet naar mij. Tim, als ik voor je sta en ik doe zo...
Ja, dat doe ik. Draai ik aan de wielen. Dat zeg ik toch.
Wat?
Op. Het was de hele dag alleen maar vers rijden. Ja, het sloopt gewoon de hele auto. Op een gegeven moment de startmotor die begon te haperen. Toen hebben we in een vallei hebben we zeker nog een uurtje gestaan. Toen heeft de brandweerman heeft ons even op sleeptouw genomen. Ja, en toen konden we heel voorzichtig doorhobbelen. Maar ja, dat was echt gewoon zorgen dat we binnenkwamen. We hebben niet meer echt kunnen rijden. Zo lekker als we gisteren reden, zo hard hebben we de klap vandaag gehad.
Dat was hem dan, de eerste week van de Dakar Rally. De rustdag is inmiddels achter de rug. En ook week 2 van de zwaarste autosportrally ter wereld is van start gegaan. Hoe het Tim en Tom Coronel vergaat, dat kun je iedere dag lezen op onze website www.studioalphen.nl. En de hoogtepunten van de tweede week van de Dakar Rally van Tim en Tom Coronel zie je volgende week op televisie bij Studio Alphen.